putting my shades on. This is always tricky now, because in the good weather, I have to think about the fact that when I get to this light up here, that there's going to be cars stopped. There's a big traffic jam coming the other way on the highway. Hey, you're listening to Drive Time with your host, Vernon Howe. This is my talk show. I'm the only person talking. Episode 25C. I filmed or taped two of these episodes at lunch, but only one of them went through. So I'm not exactly sure why we lost one. So we did. So it was just the one at lunch. I think it was the second one. That was an error on my part somehow. So I apologize for that. There's a woman stopped right here. She's about to make a... She got her blinker on. She's trying to turn into grass. I don't know what she's doing. This is... you know, we're in the summer right now. So I should talk louder, but it's kind of interesting how this dynamic's going to work with the traffic jams, because I have to worry about the perception of other people. I shouldn't care, because they're strangers. And what do I give a shit if strangers think that I'm crazy? You know, I shouldn't give a shit if anyone thinks that I'm crazy. I should just be me. I'm not hurting anyone. Certainly not even hurting myself. So I should just be me and go about being me. I will not be going to work tomorrow. I actually gotta help a family member out. I just found I gotta do a babysitting gig. I really don't know if you can hear me at all. I apologize if you can't. So like I said, tonight I'm gonna clean my car, and maybe gonna clean my garage a little bit. I'm just gonna get ready for spring, and I feel like this is a good afternoon to do that, with the weather being so nice. And it is just gorgeous out today. It's too hot, frankly. It's 80 degrees. I don't know what, you know. It was literally 41 the other day, you know. A week and a half, I mean. It's not even exaggerating. The temperature doubled in a week. So, I hate talking about global warming, because who the fuck... I mean, I don't know anything about it, really. You know? My whole thing with that is... You know, I think it is what it is in terms of being an issue, and I certainly think people have agendas on both sides. I think that you can't assume that absolutely and nothing is happening. This is all a big conspiracy, because that just negates the fact that the population explosion would not have any impact, and the fact that the population has exploded and everyone has cars, and this is such a different, you know, in the scope of evolution in the last 100 years, a lot of stuff has happened. 100 years seems like nothing, but if you look at the population increase in this time, I mean, how would we not be having some sort of impact on the environment? It's like if you looked at a glass, if you just contained it in like a glass aquarium thing with a bunch of different animals and they're all living together, and then you just, you know, you put 10 times as many animals into that space in the glass aquarium. A lot of them would die. It would be some pollution, and there'd be negative impacts across the board. You would have to assume, right? That makes sense. So the fact that like we're status quo and that this is science is bogus is it's an assault against my common sense. But that said, I'm not a scientist. So I can't tell you the exact exactly what's going on and how it's going on. And I think a lot of it's just, it's theories. It's like anything else. It's like the theory of evolution. You know, you're considered a pretty dumb person if you don't believe in the theory of evolution, but it's still a theory. I think climate change is the same way. I think, you know, the people struggling with it are gonna, it's gonna get to a point in society like the theory of evolution has. To me, the theory of evolution is probably even more abstract, but it actually, I think it ties in with this in a certain way, because what has evolution done but made us smarter and made us capable of living longer and inventing all of these on one hand beautiful things and cars and airplanes and trains and things that air conditioning and all of this energy stuff that burns resources like crazy, but they're also they make us live better lives while we're here. I don't have any issue with someone saying that they think it's a big scam to sell you something. They can think that, and they're not wrong. So you can look at it from both sides and weigh them out and be right both times. I don't see why you can't. I really believe you can. Some guy almost just flew right in front of me. We call that syndrome around these parts the crazy summer drivers. So, there's a bunch of that going on. Enjoy the weather. People who can't hear me, maybe.